or stayed home and gave up our tires so that our army could roll and our planes could land. We didn't realize how many things we could do that we hadn't done before. We made over our clothes so our soldiers could keep warm. We didn't waste electricity, and the smelters 100 miles away had more power to make steel. We sent the Navy 6 pairs of good binoculars, and an Axis raider was sunk in the Atlantic. And we didn't spend our money either. We put it to work to get our boys back home. We weren't going to face them again after all they'd been through without being able to say with a clear conscience, we did everything we could to help you. Not a little bit, or more than we thought we had to, but everything, all day, in every way we could. And in spite of the gnawing grief that was always inside us, we began to feel a little elated. There was joy in our work because we knew we could face our boys. To those who had given arms and legs and eyes, we could say that we gave not only our sickening luxuries and comforts, but our money, our thought, our skills, our work, and our sweat. It was a different town that watched our second troop march off to war. There were almost 200 of them this time. Some of them weren't as husky as others, but they could help their pals. Yes, we were a different people. We knew that through our efforts, these boys would have guns this time. Better guns than the enemy. They'd have food to sustain them, medicine to keep them well. They'd have fast planes, tough tanks, and fleets of ships to keep them supplied. They'd be better than any enemy. Their weapons would be stronger because all the ingenuity and mechanical skill of our whole great nation would be behind them. These boys would never have to surrender because we at home would never let them down. We knew that all America would learn what we had learned the hard way, that this is everybody's war. Not war for an outpost here or a naval base there, but war for every foot of American soil, every home and field, for all our friends, for all our kin. A war without compromise and without quarter. A war that must end only one way, in freedom for the world and for our little town.